Welcome back to another episode of Becoming a Practical Machinist. I'm Rebecca Wolfinger of MilSpec Manufacturing. Now, before we jump into today's episode, make sure you like, subscribe, and turn on your notifications so you never miss another episode. Let's jump into it today. According to our maintenance records, this old girl is ready for her spa day. So I figured why not turn on the camera and y'all can join me today. Our spa days, as we lovingly refer to them as, would consist of, you know, a general clean out of the interior of the machine, wiping down the exterior, checking coolant levels and concentration in the back of the coolant tank, and then of course replacing the filter and our, wait till you see it, our homemade chip bin. But this week we will be completely pumping out the coolant tank and replacing it. I even picked up the special cleaner. It's antibacterial, antifungal, and it's a degreaser. With Memorial Day weekend just ahead, I figured I'd go ahead, put this cleaner into the tank, and I'll come back in a couple days after it's been cycling through, and then we will go ahead and be cleaning it out together. I got all my supplies ready. Let's get this hair up, get some safety goggles, because guys, you can't always trust the safety squints. Let's be better. Days while continuing production. That's the nice stuff about this type of cleaner is you don't have to stop. You can just keep cutting with it. So I'll see you guys in a couple days. Happy Memorial Day weekend, everybody. I am back at the shop sporting my classic Rosie the Riveter, you know, look. But anyways, remember that cleaner that we put in a couple days ago that's been cycling through the last couple days of the week before the weekend? I am back here today to take a gander at it, and it kind of looks pretty gross. Let's go look. Oh yeah, she's nasty. I'm gonna be using this pond pump that we picked up from Harbor Freight to drain the tank. At MilSpec here, we actually keep 55-gallon drums that we use to store our spent coolant in. And you know, once those fill up, we hire a company come out, they suck it up, I think it's about $1 or $2 per gallon, but it's a lot cost effective for us to not have to run around town and find a place to dispose of it properly and have somebody else do it. Got all my spent coolant out and cleaner. I'm going to be adding in 10 gallons of water and 1.5% of my coolant mixture for a rinse cycle, which I already pre-measured out. Remember guys, oil and last. But this will be enough fluid to go ahead and get the pump to operate so I can go ahead and cycle it through the machine, all the lines, and rinse out the interior. All right, let's get it turned on. I'm gonna go reassemble my washdown hose, let this cycle through a little bit, and then I'm gonna take the hose and wash down the interior behind the doors and everything like that. I know it's an extra step to go ahead and rinse out your machine after putting that cleaner in there, but check out this tank and how much extra tramp oil we got out of there. That's just wild. Anyways, guys, we're on the last stretch of this. I'm gonna go ahead and disassemble my washdown hose once again, hook it back up to my sump pump, and pump this out so I can wipe it down the inside of the tank, change out the filter, and finally put in our fresh coolant. Grab myself some pig mat just in case we got a little bit of fluid left in there. Oh, nope, we got pretty lucky. All right, looks like we got majority of this out of here. Uh-oh. Suction cup came up on the bottom. Let me go ahead and pull this out, and then I'll pull the whole tank out and get my, shop vac, and get the rest remaining liquid in here. Now, I know a lot of people, when it comes to their chip tray, they like to just dump out the chips inside and reuse the filter. Filters are cheap. I don't mind just completely throwing away, and it saves me the headache of trying to dump everything that are, you know, caught, woven into the little filter fibers. It doesn't matter. So I'm just gonna toss this right here for now, and I'll come back to that later. But I bought these sheets. They were in the culinary industry, and they're for, you know, baked goods and stuff, but they're really versatile for the machine shop, from, you know, putting them on speed racks and using that to hold parts. But I also like to take advantage of it by putting pig mats down on that. I'm gonna grab this guy out, drain the liquid. And it's not leaking on my floor. It's gonna go right here. Throw that down here, so it can catch the tray cover in case it's leaking. Now what I'm gonna do is use my shop vac to pump the rest of this coolant out. Maybe. I got this really cool little, mesh scooper on Amazon. Just gonna take that to the bottom, try to get these little tight corners, see if there's any chip buildup before I take my pig mat and just wipe it all down. But overall, there's not really any chips in here at all. So that filter does its job pretty good. Out that chip basket, put everything back together, and finally fill this bad boy back up. Ta-da! She's all cleaned up, ready to go. I went ahead and put everything back together. I cut out a new piece of filter and put this into our chip bin. So let's slide her back in. All right, that was my last bucket of water. I'm gonna go ahead and add my coolant in and get my refractometer, and we're gonna hopefully get a concentration of between 8 to 10%. I'm gonna put half of this in, let it mix up, and then we'll check our concentration. It's always easier to add more coolant versus try to take coolant out. All right, guys, I got my refractometer out. Let's go ahead and check this concentration. It's been mixing for about an hour. Awesome. We are finally done with today's task of cleaning out the coolant. We were right in the range, and so that means I can go home, take a hot shower, and get out of these nasty clothes. Thank you so much for joining me today on today's episode of Becoming a Practical Machinist. Make sure you like, subscribe, and turn on your notifications so you never miss another episode. See you guys later.